Two. Hello, finally.
Hope you enjoyed the intro.
That was something I just did to do. It is 6 a.m. Sunday after Remembrance Day. Fireworks are still going off once in a while, which is making my PTSD go nuts.
Biscuit of choice is a hobnob, chocolate hobnob.
My favourite biscuit, I might add. And we are drinking our lovely coffee from Dave the Stormtrooper, who did survive the shipping all the way from the States. This is the original Dave, or Dave Mark II, the original Dave, same as my original Vader. Both broke in the shipping in the move from Utah to North Carolina. So this is Dave number two, and we'll be getting another Vader to go with him. It is colder than a witch's tit. And boy, do I have a lot to talk about. I got a new phone, and this thing has like no fucking reception. It's supposed to be 5G, but it's not. The fingerprint sensor is a joke. It barely recognizes my finger. The face sensor is a joke. It barely recognizes my face. And this is supposed to be an upgrade. This is supposed to be an upgrade from this. Please explain to me how this is an upgrade from this. So yes, I will be going back to this phone, and I will be selling this phone, because it is an absolute fucking joke. Up signal, supposed to be 5G when it's not. I mean, I've got less than a bar in my kitchen, as with my old phone had 3 bars. Up here in this room, I've got 2 bars. My old phone has 4 bars. Makes no fucking sense. Make it make sense to me. Been having to clean my glasses like crazy. Got to go shopping soon to pick up new microfiber cleaning cloths and a few other things. Working on some Python code and script to get a little. Basically, what I want to do is I want to take a Raspberry Pi W2, which I can now get because they're back in stock on Amazon. I want to get one of those, and I want to turn it into a portable emulating station. Basically, I want to make my not a Steam Deck per se. I already have my PlayStation 1's BIOS, because I literally ripped it from my PlayStation 1, which is over there. So it's my BIOS, it's my English BIOS. So, yeah, there's that. Been playing Star Wars Galaxies, an emulator for it, which is fun. It's always fun to play emus. Server owner is actually a pretty cool dude. He helped me with the a mission I was struggling on in space, because he had to do that mission too. And yeah, he was struggling with that mission too, and so he decided to help me with his, and then in turn helped him with his. So that was fun. It really was. I'm not kidding when I say that was fun. I mean, it really was fun. What else? See, I've been playing a lot of Star Wars Galaxies. I've also been working on my own Python scripting and whatnot for my schooling. As you guys know, I do cyber security. I'm starting up my own company, Cylon Security Solutions. And we're going to be specializing in pen testing, off site and on site. Predominantly off site for myself. And on site for some other people. I recently picked up a 24-inch monitor, a Lumia. Same make and brand as this primary display. For a tenner, Facebook marketplace, and I thought, if it's broke, I've got spare parts. If it works, great, I've got a 24-inch monitor. Fucking thing works. And it's actually, there's no dead pixels, there's no runs, there's no burnouts, there's no burnt-in images, no nothing. It's wonderful, I love it. So it's now part of the gaming rig. It's on here so I can read the chat. And bring up a website if I have to while I'm gaming on the center monitor. And the upper monitor up there has all my temperature sensing stuff. Case in point. Where are you? I never find the bloody app. Just weird, like RGB icon, Echo IQ. And with IQ, you can go to your dashboard. Dashboard. You can customize it, put videos and stuff running in the background. Yeah. But what I do, so I have it up and it tells me my GPU temperature, also mean my processing load, and everything, fan speeds, temps on everything, Corsair memory speed, 17, 17, 40, 17, 2. Yeah, I think I can tweak the RAM, get a bit more out of it, but you know, it's off-brand Chinese RAM, so I'm planning on getting some more hardware. In soon. Basically, I want to get I'll take that 32 gigs of RAM and bump it up to 64, and take the processor and bump that up. Currently my processor is 8 core 12 thread. Yeah, 8 cores, 16 thread. I want to bump that up because it's the Ryzen 7 2700. I'll whack that up to the 5300 series because that's actually come way down in price. So I'm going to grab one of those, battle with my motherboard, swap out the processors, and get an all-in-one cooler for it, as the stock cooler's not going to cool a 5000 series processor. We're going to go with the all-in-one liquid cooler, new processor, and then possibly after Christmas, probably for my birthday, more RAM. Again, mostly because this machine is my gaming machine. It's also my video editing and render machine. My old video editing and streaming machine is over there, and that's been converted into my painting PC, where I do my paint streams, as you guys know. I have another YouTube channel called Malamictus Inc. INK, where I post my model making, my model painting stuff. So you won't see any model painting videos on this channel. This channel is just the Club Shamco Ready Gaming channel. Malavages Inc. is my painting channel, where you will see me paint some miniatures, and I even stream on that PC to my Rumble and my YouTube. So I've got that going on. Got a therapy session here. 13th, so it's tomorrow. Yeah, 13th at 1 o'clock. So tomorrow at 1, I have a therapist appointment with my PTSD specialist. Because I am officially done. I'm done. Mental health is gone. It's dead. I'm just going through the motions. So got a therapist appointment tomorrow. Your mental health is a big thing, guys. It really is. It's a big, really big thing. You really should take care of your mental health. This is what I'm doing. I'm going through and I'm doing my best to take care of my mental health now, before it's too late. And if you're struggling, get help. I know that sounds like a bit of an oxymoron, but it's true. If you are struggling, get help, guys. Thank yourself for it. Also, the optician's update. I'm thinking about getting contact lenses. Cleaning these fucking things. So I'm thinking about getting contact lenses instead. So that'll be fun. It also means I'll be able to wear my cosplay stuff without worrying I'm gonna walk into someone when I'm wearing my Mando helmet. Things of that nature. So that'll be fun. So yeah, I'm gonna go into my Specsavers, that's my optometrist, and say, can these be turned into contact lenses? Please? And if they say, yeah, sure, here you go, buddy. Cue. Take that portable PSP back to my brother. I finished putting emulators on it for him. My brother's given me the go ahead to talk about this, so I'm going to talk about it now. My younger brother, he has bowel cancer. And he is fighting it. It is borderline terminal. My brother didn't want to fight it, but he's going in for surgery here in a couple of weeks. And when he goes in, I want him to have a couple of gaming devices. This is why I'm designing that Raspberry Pi to have all these emulators on it. Basically, the brain is going to be a Pi. It's going to have a 7-inch screen. It's going to have Joy-Con, because they're Bluetooth. It's going to have two Joy-Con joysticks on the side, and it's going to have batteries at the wazoo, so it lasts forever. And I am going to 3D print the cases, the front and the back case, put it together for him, and that is the goal. I'm also in the process of designing a supercar. I don't know why. I've always wanted to design a supercar. I've always wanted to design and build my own race car, and I've been watching a lot of Power Nation, which is a YouTube channel. No, it's not a KKK thing. Power Nation was formerly known as the Power Block, way back in the day. And they recently uploaded all their older content with the copyright music removed. And there's one where they take a fiberglass body of a truck, of a 30s Ford, a custom truck. I thought to myself, I need to get a hold of someone who can help me design the body for my car that I want. I want a mid-engine, rear drive, forward powered car. I don't want a DeLorean. I don't want a Fiaro. I don't want it to be a GT. I don't want it. I don't even want it to be compared to the Ford GT, because that's not it. I want this car to be my car. I want it to look like my car. I have a look in mind, in my head. It's going to be very reminiscent and throwback to the 90s. I think Jaguar XJ220 style front. But the body, the side bodies, is going to be more modern. The rear for the downforce and aerodynamics is going to be more modern. It's going to have active aero, which means depending on the speed you're going at, the aerodynamics will, you know, change. I'm trying to go for a 50-50 balance all around. At one point I was thinking all-wheel drive. I'll just stick with the mid-engine rear drive. So Ford power plant, probably Porsche gearbox. Mustang two front suspension system style up front. Better handling, better gripping, kind of thing. Probably 17 to 19 inch wheels. But big wide back fucking wheels in the back. The grip. Think Lamborghini Diablo. And seats too, carbon fiber tub, mono cockpit kind of thing. And a great big roaring 5.3, Triton 5.3. Yeah, it's been hopped up, maybe even turbo or supercharged. I'm aiming for about 800 to 900 horses. I want to get a 0 to 60 in about 4.4, 4.3. Like I said, it's not going to be a rival or replacing the GT4S. It's not possible. But it's my dream car. Sick and tired of people going, oh, my dream car's this, my dream car's that. Fuck that. Make your own dream car. Build your own. And I don't want to take a wrecked GT40. I don't want to take a Pontiac Fiaro or any of that shit. I want to build it from the frame, scratch, everything, schematics, designs, you name it. Even 3D print the body, put it through wind tunnels so I can get the aero right. Once I've got the aerodynamics correct, build a prototype, and then, you know, take it to a couple of tracks. Have people be like, what the fuck is that? Huh? And they'll be like, it's just the side on, you know? Got a very beautiful throaty exhaust system, you know? It's like that elk deer rotation on the exhaust. So, oof, I'm just picturing it in my head. It's beautiful. Beautiful. Yeah. So that's what I've been doing, guys. That's what I've got planned. That's what I've been doing. Stopped playing Water Tanks for a bit because I got burnt out on it doing the on-track thing, but I'm gonna get back into it starting today. I'll be recording some Water Tanks stuff. So, yay. That'll be nice. What else? Just thinking. I'm also going to be probably live streaming today some Star Wars Galaxies, so you guys can see what the game's all about. I said, I'm going to edit this video, just beginning, slap the intro in, and then upload it. And so, yeah. All right, guys, so thanks for hanging out. You are amazing. I've got shit to do, like clean up those pizza boxes and a few other things and whatnot. And I will see you in the next video. So stay safe, have fun, get your show flying, keep your enemies dying, put the commanders out, and happy Veterans Day to all the veterans out there.